Good morning, students. Today we are going to learn shapes and boundary of ordinates. It's come from 7th video of quantum mechanical model of atoms. Last class we have seen that the angular distribution of ordinates, the probability of finding around the nucleus in all the three axes x, y, z. Okay, so the distributions can be explained with respect to radius. Okay, from the nucleus, the probability of finding electrons around the nucleus, we calculated in three axes. We have seen last classes, x, y, z directions. Okay, today, last class we have seen that radiative distribution curve. Radiative distribution curve means where the maximum electrons are there, where the electrons tends to be zero. Those things are studied in last classes. Okay, today we are going to learn the shapes and boundary surface of orbitals. We know there is a four orbitals are there: s orbital, p orbital, d orbital, and the f orbital. S stands for shape, and p stands for principle, and d stands for diffusion, and f stands for fundamental. So these are the orbitals. We know what is in the orbital: the space or region where the probability of finding electrons are maximum around the nucleus are called as an orbital. So let me see that the shapes of orbital.
Shapes of s and p orbitals.
First, we are going to learn s orbital, the shapes of s orbital. S orbital, before going to learn the shapes of s orbital, we must know the principal quantum number. Okay, principal quantum number, asymmetric quantum number, parity quantum number, and spin quantum number. Okay, if I take n equal to 1, okay, n equal to 1 means this is a principal quantum number. This belongs to first shape. The first shape. Principal quantum number. Asymmetrical quantum number is L equal to 0. Last class itself, we discussed that S, P, D, F. For principal quantum number, the S value tends to be 0, P is 1, D is 2, and F is 3. Those things are studied in the previous class itself. Okay. So, L equal to 1 stands for principal quantum number, which belongs to first cell, first energy level. For first energy level, asymmetric quantum number L equal to 0. L equal to 0 means the magnetic quantum number is bigger than 0. That means the magnetic quantum number, the orientations have only one orientation, one possible orientation. That is the possibility of probability of finding electrons in only one orientation only. That means the nucleus, from the nucleus, if you go through the x axis or y axis, z axis, the probability of finding around all the three axes are similar. So finally we conclude that the shape of the orbital is spherical in shape. Okay, the distribution of electron around the nucleus is spherical. Whenever it is spherical, we call it as a s orbital. Okay, here I have pictured some of the s orbitals here. This is the 1s orbital. 1s orbital, 1 stands for principal quantum number. For principal quantum number, L equal to 0. L equal to 0 means m value becomes 0. Okay, m value means what? There is only one orientation. This orientation, when you see this orientation, in all the three axes will be similar. Okay, so X, Y, Z. So the distribution of electrons around the nucleus will be same. That's why it's called a spherical shape. Okay, from the nucleus, you can measure the radius and all the sides are equal. That's why we call this a spherical shape. So SR is spherical shape. This is a spherical shape. Okay, I represent the three axes, X, Y, Z. Okay, come to the second 2s orbital. 2s orbital means when n equal to 2, that means principal quantum number belongs to 2. Assuming that quantum number l equal to 0, m is also 0, it has only one orientations. That means this is a 2s orbital circle. Two spherical shapes around the nucleus. Okay, this is a two spherical shape around the nucleus, that the probability of electrons present in all three axes is that. Two spherical shapes. In between, this is a 1s orbital, this is a 2s orbital. So this is the 1s orbital is one spherical shape and 2s orbital is another spherical shape, where the probability of electrons in all the three axes will be the same. That's why we call it spherical, sphere. Okay, in between 1s and 2s, the probability of finding electrons tends to be zero. Zero. This point is called as zero because we cannot find all the electrons in those areas between a 2 sphere. Okay, that's why we call it as zero. This is called as nodal. Okay, this is called as nodal. In order to find a nodal in an orbital, there is a formula is n minus 1. You should not confuse it. See, last classes, we have seen that angular radial nodal, number of radial nodal. To find the number of radial nodal, we have used the formula n minus l minus 1. So this formula is used to find out the radial distributions. Radial, to find the radial node, we have formula n minus l minus 1, last classes. But this classes we have seen that the n minus 1 is used to find out the number of nodes in an orbital. But orbital node, the other nodes in the orbital node. Then you use this formula, n minus 1. Okay. For example, if you take a 2s orbital, we have to find out the nodal, number of nodal pair in a nodal in an orbital. We use this formula n minus 1. Let us substitute 2s. 2s means what? 2s belongs to principal quantum number. So I put 2 here. 1. So 2 minus 1, 1. There is a 1 nodal point. Yes. In between a 1s and 2s, we have only 1 nodal point. 1 nodal point means that the probability of finding electrons tends to be 0. Okay. This is a 2s orbital. Come to the 3s orbital. See. This is a 1s orbital, 2s orbital, 3s orbital. Okay. So in between 1s and 2s, there is a nodal point is there. In between 2s and 3s, there is a nodal point is there. Actually, two nodal points are there in a 3 spherical. Okay. So 3s orbital is nothing but 3 spherical orbitals around the nucleus in x, y, z directions. The distribution of electron will be same in all these 3s orbitals. That's why they are called as a 3 spherical sphere. Okay. In between those 3 spherical sphere, we have two nodal points. The formula is n minus 1. Substitute here 3s, 3 minus 1, we have only two nodal points. So this is one nodal point, another nodal point is here, where the probability of finding electron tends to be 0. Okay, let us come to p orbitals. Okay, p orbital is used to always comes to n equal to 2. Okay, n equal to 2 means principal quantum number. Principal quantum number is like it belongs to second shell, second energy level. Okay, p comes only second energy level. Okay. In this, L has value 1. L belongs to 1. L is nothing but asymptotic quantum number. Asymptotic quantum number value is 1. What about M? M equal to plus or minus 1. Plus or minus 1 means, listen here, there is a 3 types of orientations are there. 3 possible orientations are there in a 2p orbital. This is belongs to 2p orbital. Okay. Because why I am calling 2p? 2 is comes from second shell, second energy level. The p orbital comes only in starts with the second orbital only. So this is a 2p orbital. 2p orbital having a magnetic quantum number is minus 1, 0, plus 1. That's why I put plus or minus 1. That means 3 possible orientations are there. Okay. See, I represent the orbital in a structure form. This is the orbital. This is the 2p orbital. This 2p orbital having a 3 suborbital. Px, Py, Pz. Okay, minus 1, 0, 1. That's why H is M equal to plus or minus 1. There is a 3 types of orientations are there. The orbital oriented in the x direction, the orbital oriented in y direction, the orbital oriented in the z directions. Okay. So there is a three types of orientations are possible. Okay. This is the shapes of a p orbital. This shape is called as a dumbbell shape. This is called as a dumbbell. Okay, dumbbell shape. This dumbbell shape, no? This we call as a loops. We call as loops. This all called as a loops. The probability of electron finding in two loops will be the same. But in between a two loops, there is a nodal point is there. Where the probability of electron tends to be zero. Okay, so you can find the maximum electron in this area and maximum electron in this area. So, but in between the two loops, the distribution of electron tends to be zero. That's why we call this nodal point. Okay, so we know the formula n minus 1 is a nodal point. Okay, so this is a px orbital. Why it's called as px orbital? This dumbbell orbital px is oriented in x direction. That's why it's called as a px orbital. But here, py orbital, okay, because this orbital is oriented in a y direction. This orbital is oriented in a z direction. Okay, we can draw this diagram with the plane of paper. Okay, for example, imagine that this is a plane of paper. So this is the orbital. Okay, this is the p orbital. Actually, it's a belongs to the y axis. So you can rotate here. Okay, consider that z, pz. Pz, you can clearly tell that the plane of paper is like this, but p orbital is perpendicularly oriented. It rotates in a pz direction. Okay, so these are called as nodal points. These are the three suborbital of px, py, pz of p orbitals. This we call as loops. Okay, this is the assumption only. This is the assumption that the property of finding electron out of the nucleus. For example, I can show the assumption here. Let me listen again. This is a nucleus point. Consider this is a nucleus. So in this point, so this is called as p orbital. Likewise, the probability of orbital around the nucleus like in this form. If it is rotated in x direction, it is a px, y direction is py, z direction is pz. Okay, these are called as shapes of p orbital.
Shapes of d orbitals.
Let me come to the shapes of d orbital. Okay, d. Okay, so we stand for deficiency. Okay, d orbital comes from third shell, third energy level. That's why we call it as a third energy level, 3d. Okay, then 4d, 5d, it's going on. Okay, 3d orbital. For 3d orbital, the principal quantum number is 3. Okay, azimuthal quantum number L is given as 2. What about the magnetic quantum number? Magnetic quantum number tells about plus or minus 2. Plus or minus 2 means what? Plus or minus 2. Plus or minus means we can tell minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2. That means it has 5 possible orientations are there. There is a 5 possible orientations. The orbitals can have 5 possible orientations around the nucleus. It can rotate. These are the 5 possible orientations. This we call as dxy, dyz, dxz, dx square, y square, dz square. There is a possible, 5 possible orientations are there. Okay, so let me discuss here. Consider this is a d orbital having a 5 suborbitals are there. Okay, this we call as dxy, dyz, dxz, dx square minus y square, dz square. Okay, so this orbitals I have represents in the following diagram. Okay, so this is minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2. That's why the magnetic quantum number is equal to plus or minus 2. Okay, so here let me discuss about the shapes of d orbital. So shapes of d orbitals are split up into two categories. The two categories, this one category, another this category. This category is called as T2G. Okay, this category is called as EG level. Okay. EG levels. 3-2 means this is a triple fusion. Triple fusion is three types of this three are belongs to one type and this two are belongs to another type. Okay, that's why these are triple fusions. Okay, G stands for degeneracy. Okay, degeneracy. Okay, degeneracy means all combined together. This is called as d orbitals. This d orbitals subdivided into three categories. This is a dxy, dyz, dxz. Let me come to the first figure, the dxy. Okay, dxy means this are called as loops. These loops are placed in between a two axes. This is the x axis, this is y axis. In between the axis are loops are there. So this is one axis, another one is axis are there. So these two, the loops are present in between the x and y. That's why they are called as a dxy orbitals. Okay. So this are excess, this is called as a nodal point. The distribution of electron in these loops is equal to this loop, and distribution of electron in this area is equal to that area. Okay. Likewise, YZ. Okay. YZ is also similar to the two loops are placed in between Y and Z. Okay, in between Y axis and Z axis, the two loops. Same similar to XY. Like XZ, the two loops. Yeah, the two loops are placed in between X and Y form. Okay, they rotate, the possibles are there. Okay, these are three types. Okay, this we call as a clubber leaf shape. Clubber leaf shape. This is called as clubber leaf shape. Okay, and comes to another second part of DR description, DX square, Y square. So these two loops are lying in the axis itself. Okay, but here the two loops are present in between the axis, but here the loops are present in axis. One is x axis, another one is y axis. That's why it's called as a dx square, y square. Okay, the orientation takes place x axis and y axis. Okay, this is also called as a clubber leaf shape because it's like a leaf having a four petals. Okay, clubber leaf shapes. Come to the dz square. Dz square means the loops are only rotated in a z axis. Okay, perpendicular axis to the plane of the orbital. Consider this is a plane. Okay, since the orbitals and loops are rotated in a along the z axis, that way it's called as dz square. This is called as governor shape. Okay, governor shape. This is called as a clever leaf shape. Okay, clever shape or clever leaf shapes. Okay, this is called as a d orbitals. Okay, d orbital at the end, these are called as a degeneracy orbitals in absence of magnetic field. Okay, that means what? This all the d orbitals have same energy. Okay, equal energy. Dxy, dyz, dxz square, dzz square, all the pi atoms having the same energy in absence of the magnetic field. If we apply any external magnetic field there, the degeneracy will be cancelled. Okay, the energy difference will be takes place between those pi orbitals. Okay, that's why it is called as a degeneracy orbitals. Okay, it is split up into T2G and E2G. Okay, this we study in gold standard. T stand for triple fusions. Okay, triple form of d orbitals. Triple success. 1, 2, 3. Okay, next. Once again, I repeat in Tamil. Okay, this part is shapes of s orbital. The shapes of s orbital. What is it? S orbital the shape will be a spherical shape. Yes, spherical shape. But our orbital, what is it? Our other distribution of electrons, what is similar. எல்லா எக்ஸ் ஒய் இசட் மூணு டைரக்ஷன்லயும் சேமா இருக்கும் நீங்க சுத்தி. அதனால தான் அது ஸ்பெரிக்கல் ஷேப் நம்ம சொல்றோம். ஓகே, அது ஸ்பெரிக்கல். இது வந்து 1s ஆர்பிட், இது வந்து 2s ஆர்பிட். 1s ஆர்பிட் 2s ஆர்பிட் ஒரு கேப் பாருங்க, எலக்ட்ரான்ஸ் தான் இருக்காரு, அதுக்கு பேர் தான் நோடல் பாயிண்ட் அர்த்தம். அப்ப நோடல் பாயிண்ட் கண்டுபிடிக்கக்கூடிய ஃபார்முலா கேட்டா n-1 னு சொல்லுவோம். சார் நீங்க போன கிளாஸ் நடத்துறீங்களா, அது n-1 நடத்துறீங்களா, இப்ப ஏன் n-1 சொல்றீங்க அப்படிங்கிட்ட, போன கிளாஸ் வந்து நம்ம ரேடியன்ட் நோடு கண்டுபிடிச்சோம். ரேடியன்ட் நோடு இதுதான் எஸ் ஆர்பிட்டல் ஸ்பெரிக்கல் ஷேப். ஓகே, எஸ் ஆர்பிட்டல் பொறுத்த வரைக்கும் எல்இ டு ஜீரோ அசிமுத்தல் கோணத்தில் நம்பர் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா எஸ்ஓட வேலை ஜீரோ இருந்தால் தான் அது ஸ்பெரிக்கல் ஷேப் நம்ம சொல்றோம். அதுக்கு ஒரே ஒரு ஓரியன்டேஷன் தான் எல்இ டு ஜீரோ. ஓகே, ஒரே பாசிபிள் ஓரியன்டேஷன் தான், அந்த ஓரியன்டேஷன் எல்லா டைரக்ஷன் எல்லாம் அவங்ககிட்ட சேமா இருக்கு. ஸ்பெரிக்கல் ஷேப். இப்போ பி ஆர்பிட்டல் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா, பி ஆர்பிட்டல் வந்து செகண்ட் டிஷன் தான் வரும். அதனால தான் எல்இ டு டூன்னு சொல்றோம். அதுக்கு எல்லோட வேல்யூ கேட்டால் 1, எம்ஓட வேல்யூ வந்து ப்ளஸ் ஆர் மைனஸ் 1, மைனஸ் 1 0 1
Shapes of F orbitals.
That is comes to the last one, that is called as the F orbital. F is stand for fundamental. Okay, F orbital in this level, fourth energy level. It comes from fourth energy level. That means n equal to 4. 4 means principal quantum number. A principal quantum number n equal to 4. Okay, asymmetric quantum number, or the value of asymmetric quantum number for d. Okay, d, my asymmetric quantum number for f, 3. Okay. Magnetic quantum number plus or minus 3. Okay, plus or minus 3. That means what? Minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3. That means there is 7 possible types of orientations are fixed in the nucleus. Okay, that is a magnetic quantum number, it has an orientation of an orbital. There is 7 possible orientations are in the nucleus in an orbital. Okay, this 7 types of orientation can be represented here. See, these are the suborbital of F orbitals. Okay, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 7 orbitals are there. So, there is 7 types of orientation is possible. First type of orientation is F is a cube. Okay, then F x is a square. F y is a square. F x y is a type. F is a x square into x square y square. Fx into x square minus 3y square. Fy into 3x square minus y square. These are the orientations, okay? Orientations of F orbitals. Okay, F orbital diagram is a bit complicated. Okay, if you, if you find any difficult for this diagram, just you go through your textbook. Okay, textbook there is given that. So this is F orbitals. Seven type of F orbitals. Seven possible orientations of S orbitals. F orbitals are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 and 7. So the number 6 in this form. Okay, this is called the F orientations. F orientation is nothing but 7 types of orientations are there. Okay, so these are the shapes of F orbital. Kandipa definite shapes of orbital to a question. Okay, SR is the shape experiment, PR is the shape experiment, DR is the shape experiment, FA experiment. Most of F take a okay, because F or a diagram with a complicated, they won't ask that shapes of F orbital, but you must know. Okay, F orbital nodal point here. What is the nodal point? And you get the formula, the nodal point, and you get a formula. N minus 1 formula. Up a fourth shell, FA will have a four of the nodal point, you will get a 4 minus 1, you know, there is a 3 nodal points are there. Okay, yaarukku F orbital irundhu moonu vandu nodal point irukku andha adula moonu edathilume the distribution of electrons vandu enna varum appdi ketta zero varum. Okay, so idhu vandu oru mukkiyamaana question sir, shapes of the ungalku S orbital, P orbital, D orbitals. Okay, andha ungalku vandu PDF ah na notes anupra assignment notes ah kandipa varum the S orbital, P orbital, D orbital pathi adha neenga podikonga adha paathu padikalam. Next topic pathina we are going to learn energy of an orbitals. Okay, energy of orbitals. First energy is an orbital, second energy is third, fourth energy. Then the nucleus is first distance, second distance, third distance, and point. Then energy is going to be given. Other than the first class, they have the most mass density. They are given a formula. Energy is going to be En equal to minus 1312 Z square divided by N square. Kilojoule per mole. So this formula is used to find out the energy of the orbitals. Okay. Now energy of orbitals increase. F increase when N equal to increases. N increase or increase, energy will increase. Okay. Orbital orbital is going on increases with the energy. So in this class we are going to see that the energy of orbitals very clearly. Okay. So far we have finished 80% of topic. Only remaining 20% will be developed here in a quantum mechanical model. Next class, most probably we are going to complete these lessons. So whenever I complete these lessons, students, you have to be ready. Next day itself, I am going to conduct a test. So do your assignment with them honestly. Okay, don't copy. Simply copy and ready. So it's a waste. It's a useless. சும்மா அப்படியே நீங்கள் கொடுத்த புக்கை பார்த்து அப்படியே எழுதி போஸ்ட் பண்ணுறது வந்து யூஸ்லெஸ்ஸாக இருக்குது. ஓகே, படித்து கரெக்ஷன் பண்ணி அந்த நோட்ஸை எனக்கு அனுப்புங்க. இந்த ஷேப்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஆர்டர் வந்து டயக்ராம் போட்டு கிளியராக நீங்கள் பண்ணி அனுப்புங்க. ஓகே, கம்மிங் நெக்ஸ்ட் வீக் ஆன்வர்ஸ் விஆர் கோயிங் டு விஆர் ஹேவிங் ஏ டூ கிளாஸஸ் ஃபார் கெமிஸ்ட்ரி. ஓகே, கெமிஸ்ட்ரி இன்னொரு டாபிக் தனியாக போவோம், இந்த டாபிக் தனியாக போவோம். ஓகே, ஸோ டியர் ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ், டூ த அசைன்மெண்ட்டு வெரி ஹானஸ்ட்லி. தேங்க்யூ.